KSTP-TV, St. Paul, Minneapolis, Channel 5.
Channel 5, Minneapolis, St. Paul. From KSTP News Headquarters for the Northwest, tomorrow's news tonight. This is the KSTP News 10 o'clock report with John McDougall. Brought to you by the folks at NSP who invite you to bring your life up to date to live better electrically.
Good evening, everyone.
Eyewitness News at 5 with meteorologist Dennis Falcon and newscaster Cindy Bricado.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Eyewitness News. The Northwest's most complete, comprehensive, and up-to-the-minute coverage. With meteorologist Dr. Walt Lyons, sportscaster Tom Ryder, and anchorman Ron Majors.
Good evening. A gunshot was fired in the vicinity of President Ford late this afternoon.
Eyewitness News, the Northwest's most complete, comprehensive, and up-to-the-minute coverage with meteorologist Dr. Walt Lyons, sportscaster Tom Ryder, and Stan Turner for anchorman Ron Majors.
Good evening, everyone, and the headlines this Tuesday evening.
Eyewitness News, the Northwest's most complete, comprehensive, and up-to-the-minute coverage with meteorologist Dennis Falcon, sportscaster Bob Bruce, and newscasters Ron Majors and Cindy Brucato.
Good evening. For the first time today,
Eyewitness News, the Northwest's most complete, comprehensive, and up-to-the-minute coverage with meteorologist Dennis Falcon, sportscaster Bob Bruce, and newscaster Stan Turner.
Good evening, everyone. Cindy Brucato has the night off.
Eyewitness News, the Northwest's most complete, comprehensive, and up-to-the-minute coverage with meteorologist Dennis Falcon, sportscaster Bob Bruce, and newscasters Stan Turner and Cindy Brucato.
Good evening, everyone.
Eyewitness News, the Northwest's most complete, comprehensive, and up-to-the-minute coverage with meteorologist Dennis Falcon, sportscaster Rob Lear, and anchorman Stan Turner.
Good evening, everyone. It was take it or leave it at the Minnesota Capitol today.
Eyewitness News, the Northwest's most complete, comprehensive, and up-to-the-minute coverage with weatherman Roy Findon, sportscaster Bob Bruce, and anchorman Stan Turner.
Good evening, everyone. Mother Nature, an angry Mother Nature, is making much of the big news this Saturday evening.
Eyewitness News, the Northwest's most complete, comprehensive, and up-to-the-minute coverage with meteorologist Dennis Falcon, sportscaster Bob Bruce, and newscasters Cindy Brucato and Stan Turner.
Good evening, everyone.
Eyewitness News, the Northwest's most complete, comprehensive, and up-to-the-minute coverage with meteorologist Dave Dahl, sportscaster Bob Bruce, newscasters Stan Turner and Cindy Brucato.
Good evening, everyone.
This is Eyewitness News Morning with newscasters Tom Green and Karen Carnes, meteorologist Karen Falloon, and sportscaster Ed Cairo.
And good morning. Well, today is Monday, the 10th of October. Now, Cindy Brucato, Dennis Bounds, and meteorologist Dennis Felkin. This is Eyewitness News at 5. Now, Cindy Brucato, Stan Turner, meteorologist Dennis Felkin, and Bob Bruce with sports. This is Eyewitness News. Now, Marcia Fleur, meteorologist Dave Dahl, and Larry Burnett with sports. This is Eyewitness News.
Good evening.
Now, Cindy Brucato, Stan Turner, meteorologist Dennis Felkin, and Bob Bruce with sports. The Eyewitness News Update.
Good evening, everyone. Well, you saw it all tonight here on Channel 5, live from the Dome. The Minnesota Vikings and the Dallas Cowboys brought down the curtain in style.
Now, Stan Turner, Marcia Fleur, meteorologist Dave Dahl, and Larry Burnett with sports. This is Eyewitness News.
It has been the kind of cold that takes your breath away. Temperatures of more than 20 below all day. Wind chill factors reaching 80 degrees below and more.
Good evening and Merry Christmas. We hope all of the clothing fit, all of the toys worked, and aren't you glad you bought that sled for your kids for Christmas?
Good evening once again, and welcome to the special report on what we are calling Fire on the Mall.
Now, Cindy Brucato, Stan Turner, Dennis Felkin, and Bob Bruce. This is Eyewitness News.
St. Anthony, New Brighton, and Moundsview were the hardest hit by high wind.
Now, Cindy Brucato, Stan Turner, Dennis Felkin, and Bob Bruce. This is the Eyewitness News Update.
Tonight in St. Paul.
Good evening, everybody. We will be going back to the Summer Olympic Games in Los Angeles after this abbreviated version of the Eyewitness News Update.
Now, from Minnesota's leading news station, Cindy Brucato, Stan Turner, Dennis Belkin, and Bob Bruce. This is Eyewitness News.
And good evening, everyone. Cindy is on vacation.
Now, from Minnesota's leading news station, Cindy Brucato, Stan Turner,
Dennis Belkin, and Bob Bruce. This is the Eyewitness News Update. Now, from Minnesota's leading news station, Cindy Brucato, Stan Turner, Dennis Belkin, and Bob Bruce. This is the Eyewitness News Update.
Good evening, everyone.
Now, the news continues with the team that covers the Twin Cities and all of Minnesota. This is Eyewitness News at 6.
Seven weeks after 13-year-old Sarah Raridan disappeared.
Now, the team that covers the Twin Cities and all of Minnesota brings you the latest news tonight. This is the Eyewitness News Update.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Angela Storr.
Now, the team that covers the Twin Cities and all of Minnesota brings you the latest news tonight. This is the Eyewitness News Update.
The latest news tonight. This is the Eyewitness News Update.
KSTP-TV, Minnesota's News Channel 5.
Live from Minnesota's News Channel, KSTP Channel 5, this is Eyewitness News Morning.
Good morning, everyone. It's 6 o'clock on this Wednesday, July the 15th.
Live from Minnesota's News Channel, KSTP Channel 5, Frank Somerville, Wendy Lubavitch, Bill Ranby, and Ed Caro bring you Eyewitness News Morning.
And good morning, everyone.
Live from Minnesota's News Channel, KSTP Channel 5, Bob Bruce, Wendy Lubavitch, Karen Falloon, and Joe Schmidt bring you Eyewitness News Morning.
Good morning, 24 degrees on the outside.
Live from Minnesota's News Channel, KSTP Channel 5, Stan Turner, Ruth Spencer, Dave Dahl, and Joe Schmidt bring you Eyewitness News live at 5.
And good afternoon, everyone.
You're watching KSTP-TV, Minnesota's News Channel 5.
Live from Minnesota's News Channel, KSTP Channel 5, Mark Sapelsa, Angela Astor, Dave Dahl, and Mark Curtis bring you Eyewitness News, live at 5.
I come.
Live from Minnesota's News Channel, KSTP Channel 5, Stan Turner, Ruth Spencer, Dave Dahl, and Bob Bruce bring you Eyewitness News at 6.
Good evening, everyone.
Live from Minnesota's News Channel, KSTP Channel 5, Stan Turner, Ruth Spencer, Dave Dahl, and Mark Curtis bring you Eyewitness News at 6.
This is a live picture of the uptown area in Minneapolis.
Live from Minnesota's News Channel, KSTP Channel 5, Stan Turner, Ruth Spencer, Dave Dahl, and Joe Schmidt bring you the Eyewitness News Update.
Good evening, everyone.
Live from Minnesota's News Channel, KSTP Channel 5, Stan Turner, Ruth Spencer, Dave Dahl, and Mark Curtis bring you the Eyewitness News Update.
Baseball's tops in the American League met for the first time under the big top tonight.
Live from Minnesota's news channel, KSTP Channel 5, Mike Binkley, Karen Falloon, and Mark Stevens bring you the Eyewitness News Update.
It was a hero's welcome tonight for the team that's the best in the West.
Live from Minnesota's news channel, KSTP Channel 5, Angela Astor, Karen Falloon, and Rob Lear bring you Eyewitness News.
Good evening, everyone.
Live from Minnesota's news channel, KSTP Channel 5, Stan Turner, Ruth Spencer, Dave Dahl, and Mark Curtis bring you Eyewitness News. Live from Minnesota's news channel, KSTP Channel 5, Mike Binkley, Karen Falloon, and Mark Stevens bring you Eyewitness News. Live from Minnesota's news channel, KSTP Channel 5, this is Eyewitness News.
Good evening, everyone. Passengers on a Northwest plane.
Channel 5, Minnesota's news channel, and the Minnesota Twins channel for the 1987 World Series. KSTP Channel 5, first in Minnesota. Live from Channel 5, this is Eyewitness News with Stan Turner, Kirsten Lindquist, and the entire Eyewitness News team.
Good evening, everyone.
KSTP, Minnesota's News Channel 5. Now, live, this is Eyewitness News.
It's this scene, political prisoner Nelson Mandela walking through a prison gate to freedom.
KSTP, Minnesota's News Channel 5. Now, live, this is Eyewitness News with Stan Turner, Kirsten Lindquist, sports with Joe Schmidt, weather with Phil Schwartz, and the entire Eyewitness News team.
And good evening, everybody. Thank you very much for joining us here tonight.
You're watching KSTP Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. Now, live from your 24-hour news channel, Wendy Lubavitch, Dave Taylor, and meteorologist Cliff Michelson. Eyewitness News Morning continues.
Good morning, everyone. 6:31 on a Tuesday morning.
You're watching KSTP Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. And now, live from your 24-hour news channel, Angela Astor, Mark Sapelsa, meteorologist Dave Dahl, and Dr. Michael Breen. This is Eyewitness News, live at 5.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Wendy Lubavitch.
And I'm Randy Meyer.
You're watching KSTP Channel 5. St. Paul, Minneapolis. And now, live from your 24-hour news channel, Mark Sapelsa, Val Holly Dennis, and meteorologist Dave Dahl. This is Eyewitness News, live at 5.
Good afternoon to you.
This is KSTP Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. Live from your 24-hour news channel, this is Eyewitness News Live at 5.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight, major developments in the story that's dominated the headlines all week long.
Los Angeles police charge O.J. Simpson with the murders of his ex-wife, Nicole.
This is KSTP Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. Live from your 24-hour news channel, this is Eyewitness News.
A very secure jail.
This is KSTP Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. Live
from your 24-hour news channel. This is Eyewitness News at 6. This is KSTP Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. Live from your 24-hour news channel. This is Eyewitness News at 6.
And good evening, everyone. Our top story tonight.
You're watching KSTP Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. And now live from your 24-hour news channel, Angela Astor, Mark Sepulsa, meteorologist Dave Dahl, and Joe Schmidt with sports. This is Eyewitness News at 10.
As Winston Churchill said, jaw, 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 or talk, talk, talk is better than war, war, war.
This is KSTP-TV, Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. Tonight's top story.
You're looking live at a home in Shoreview. It's one of several murder scenes across the metro area tonight.
This is KSTP-TV, St. Paul, Minneapolis. Straight ahead on Channel 5's Eyewitness News at 10.
Find out why the Minnesota Twins may find a new home outdoors.
Tonight's top story.
What does the president's health plan mean to you and your wallet?
Plus,
is all this enough to make you do your shopping downtown?
Stay tuned.
Police find their suspect from this Halloween night murder.
Now, Eyewitness News.
Our top story tonight is one that will affect you, your family, and your job, no matter who you are.
This is KSTP Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. Live from your 24-hour news channel. This is Eyewitness to the Week.
You're watching KSTP Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. Now, live from your 24-hour news channel, Dave Taylor and the entire Eyewitness News team. This is Eyewitness News All Night.
You're watching KSTP Channel 5, St. Paul, Minneapolis. Now, live from your 24-hour news channel, Stan Turner and the entire Eyewitness News team. This is Eyewitness News.
Allegations of rape and a cover-up at a Twin Cities college.
Live from KSTP-TV, St. Paul, Minneapolis. This is Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 6.
You're watching Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 6 with Chris Canangla, Angela Astor, Joe Schmidt with sports, and meteorologist Dave Dahl with Doppler Radar 5.
Live from KSTP-TV, St. Paul, Minneapolis. This is Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 6:30.
Students pour out of one suburban high school for lunch today.
This is Total Coverage on Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 6:30. Tonight's top story.
How high will they go before gas prices get out of hand?
Live from KSTP-TV, St. Paul, Minneapolis, this is Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 10.
This is Total Coverage on Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 10. Tonight's top story.
These wild bear cubs are caught in a classic
You're watching KSTP Channel 5. Now, with news that matters to you, this is Channel 5 Eyewitness News Midday.
Thank you for joining us this midday.
You're watching KSTP Channel 5. Now, with news that matters to you, this is Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 6.
Governor Jesse Ventura had to navigate some rough water with his first pick to head the Department of Natural Resources.
On Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 6:30, tonight's top story.
Folks are bugging out. Minnesotans get evicted by floodwaters that take over their homes.
Live from KSTP Television, this is Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 6:30.
Hundreds of cabbies fight for your fare.
This is Total Coverage
on Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 10. Tonight's top story.
This is just a huge flood. It just overwhelmed.
Live from KSTP Television, this is Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 10.
A vandal tries to pull the plug on this massive 40-year tradition in the Twin Cities. Good evening. It's one of the most frequent stops for people out looking at Christmas lights. But
live from KSTP-TV, this is Channel 5 Eyewitness News Morning.
Good morning. It's Friday, November 10th.
You're watching Channel 5 Eyewitness News Morning with Mike Binkley, Angela Davis, Jim Guy with weather, and Rusty Gatenby with traffic.
Welcome back. It's 14 minutes after 5.
Live from KSTC-TV, this is Channel 45 Eyewitness News Morning.
We are giving you a live look this morning.
You're watching Channel 5 Eyewitness News Midday with John Stone, Lindsay Polo, and Mike LaPointe with weather. You're watching Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 6 with Randy Meyer, Julie Nelson, Dave Dahl with weather, and Joe Schmidt with sports. Live from KSTP-TV, this is Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 6:30.
It's in our country.
Live from KSTC-TV, this is Channel 45 Eyewitness News at 9.
Live from KSTP-TV, this is Channel 5 Eyewitness News at 10.
This research offers the potential to eliminate diseases.
Minnesotans like dope. That's what it's about. There's a demand here for drugs.
And that's why gang-related murders are on the rise. Tonight, what police plan to do about it. Good evening, I'm Randy Meyer. Julie is off tonight.
Tonight on Eyewitness News, walking down the street and how the punch probe. And only on 5, will it be a wild finish for this future Hall of Famer? Then, oh, what a difference a year makes in flood-ravaged Roseau. And legal action in St. Paul. Two police officers face a $1 million lawsuit. First tonight.
It is opening day, and we are out at Hazeltine National Golf Club where practice rounds got underway in the 2002 PGA Championship.
Leading with more news, this is 5 Eyewitness News at 6. Leading with more news, you're watching 5 Eyewitness News at 10.
Only on 5, Minneapolis police investigating new accusations of excessive force.
You're watching 5 Eyewitness News at 10 with Cindy Brocato, Dave Dahl with weather, and Joe Schmidt with sports. This is 5 Eyewitness News Morning.
We can never be prepared for something as horrendous as this.
Eyewitness News Weekend Mornings.
A third day of searching now for victims getting underway in the tragic 35W bridge collapse.
This is 5 Eyewitness News at 5.
We start with the latest from the 35W bridge collapse.
This is 5 Eyewitness News at 6.
I run for the Senate in 2008 and I win.
He's hinted at it for months and tonight it's official. Al Franken is running for the U.S. Senate.
This is 5 Eyewitness News at 10.
Tonight, standing united.
We could see that the entire bridge was gone and then it set in there that this was a big deal.
This is 5 Eyewitness News at 10.
We start tonight with breaking news in Maplewood.
jobs are on the minds of millions of Americans, and today Governor Dayton is hoping to find solutions to the state's economic challenges.
Live from the studios of 5 Eyewitness News, it's Twin Cities Live with your hosts, John Hansen and Rebecca Wood.
A deadly crash involving a truck carrying millions of bees. Firefighters deal with the swarm before they can get to the victims. Tonight, for the first time,
all I felt was a big boom and a bunch of bangs.
We're hearing from the driver of that bee truck.
And we just learned in the last 30 minutes, a second person has died.
New graphic charges filed against a former St. Paul school janitor.
A fallen police officer honored for his bravery, kindness, and making the ultimate sacrifice.
We begin with a developing story tonight. An investigation is underway after a woman is killed in an East St. Paul neighborhood.
Good morning. Glad you're with us this morning. We want to get started with some breaking news.
We are an American family, and we rise or fall together as one nation and as one people.
4 more years for President Obama. He defeated Mitt Romney after nearly sweeping all of the battleground states. Presidential race, of course, just a fraction of our election coverage this morning.
Remembering a music icon, fans have been paying tribute all night long to Minnesota's very own Prince. We're live outside First Avenue, where the party is still going on.
We begin this Sunday evening.
To disrupt the lives of 375,000 individuals.
It's being called the biggest shakeup to the communications industry in 2 decades.
They can have that free time without someone breathing down your neck about it.
The Saint. The same drug that killed Prince took the life of a man who knew him well.
It's shock. It's really shock.
Now it's 6 o'clock and it's... Now it's 7 o'clock.
Thanks for joining us on 5 Eyewitness News. I'm Paul Folger.
And I'm Jackie Kane.
5 Eyewitness News starts right now.
5 Eyewitness News starts right now. Now at 6, we're taking a live look from inside the U.S. House of Representatives.
Tragedy strikes small town Minnesota.
Eyewitness News on 45 starts right now.
We all love you and we just want you to get home safe.
5 Eyewitness News starts right now.
Long-term care facilities across Minnesota are in the middle of a serious battle right now.
Good evening. I'm meteorologist Ren Claire with your forecast first.
Tonight on Nightcast, moments of terror.
Hey, I knew I was hearing gunshots.
Deadly gunfire at a Colorado grocery store, sending shoppers and staff scrambling for safety.
I just left my cart, all the groceries. A large group of us all just started running towards the back of the store.
Spring break scare.
The shark, it was trying to eat me.
A Minnesota boy bitten just minutes into a Florida vacation.
Family says he needed surgery. He could face some mobility issues. But doctors say his outlook is good.
I'm okay.
I'm doing better.
Not finished yet.
Jury selection in the Derek Chauvin murder trial will be extended for at least one more day.
We're going to call in 12 and we're going to get through 12, however long it takes tomorrow.
It's a laced-up landmark.
I've never seen anything like this before.
Shrouded in mystery.
This is the University of Minnesota shoe tree.
Shoes started appearing and different reasons started emerging for why that could be.
And a new era begins.
Ben Johnson has never been a head coach at any level, but he will take over as the head coach of the Golden Gopher basketball program.
Can't tell you how excited I am to get back home.
The biggest question on Ben Johnson is, can he handle the role of a head coach?
Those stories and more on this Monday, March 22nd, 2021. Good evening. I'm Kevin Dorn, and this is Nightcast.
It's 8:27. Good morning. Chris Eggert here with a quick check of your Monday morning headlines. Now it's 7 o'clock.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. I'm Leah McClain. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us today.
Live from the 5 Eyewitness News Studios, it's Twin Cities Live with your hosts, Elizabeth Reese and Steve Patterson.
Hi. Welcome in.
Oh, I think this is so cute, Steve. There's a kindergarten teacher from Washington going viral for his virtual field trip to the zoo.
It's Twin Cities Live at 4 with Elizabeth Reese and Steve Patterson.
Hello.
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 Nice to see you.
Glad you're with us today at 4:30. I'm Paul Folger.
And I'm Jackie Kane. We begin with meteorologist Ren Clare.
And first at 5, police say a 21-year-old man is now charged with 10 counts of first-degree murder.
And first at 6, jury selection in the Derek Chauvin murder trial will be extended for at least one more day.
First at 6:30, we are tracking a developing story in Colorado.
Thanks for joining us at 9. Happy Friday. We've made it to the weekend forecast.
Tonight on Nightcast, Minnesota's mask mandate, a thing of the past.
I would call for a motion to approve Executive Order 2123.
So moved.
It comes on the heels of new guidance from the CDC that says fully vaccinated Americans no longer need masks in most situations.
But you may still need them more than you think.
We certainly respect the decisions being made by local jurisdictions to perhaps keep their mask mandates.
A glimpse inside hostage negotiating.
The truth is, all you want to focus on is the relationship you build with the person in crisis.
A week after, bank employees were held in St. Cloud.
You certainly don't want to walk in like you're in charge of the situation.
That first thing you say to that person could determine how this whole negotiation goes.
A pandemic jolt.
We had to pivot very quickly.
Best Buy's former CEO talks to us about the challenges and the lessons learned.
We discovered that our employees are human beings. Business cannot do well, you know, if the community is suffering.
Those stories and more on this Friday, May 14th, 2021.
Good evening, I'm Lindsay Brown. This is Nightcast.
Channel 5 Eyewitness News, Minnesota's news leader.